Hey guys, in this video I'll be showing you how to do this kind of a rotation transition inside of Premiere Pro. Now I have made a preset on this and the download link will be in the description down below. It's completely free. And first I'll be showing you how I made this preset and then I'll show you how to use this preset. So basically I have two different clips on the timeline right now and say I want the transition to be between them. So I want to make a cut at the end of the first clip and in the beginning of the second clip. The duration of the transition will depend on the size of the cut you make. So if it's a long cut, obviously it's going to be long, and a small cut will make the transition to be short. So I'll press shift and left arrow 6 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I came 30 seconds back and control K to make a cut over here, that's a shortcut. Go back and then shift plus right arrow 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times, oh, I mean 6 times, and control K there to make a cut. So basically I have these two cuts, and what I did is first I searched an effect called replicate. It's under stylize, and I dragged and dropped onto both of them. Now the count is set to 3. You want to scale it just so that it fits your composition. I think 300. Yeah, 300 fits perfectly. So I'm gonna do that for the other cut as well. Count to be 3 and scale to be 300. And then I search another effect called, let me see, was it? Yeah, it's twirl. It's called twirl. It's under distort. And again, I'm gonna select both of them and I'm gonna drag and drop on them. So it drops on both of them. Set the keyframe on angle at the beginning, and at the end of the cut, I'm gonna set the angle to 180. Also, I'll select the second cut, and at the beginning of the second cut, I wanna make the angle to be about 180, and then at the end of the second cut, I wanna bring it back to 0. So basically, we got something like this. Now after that, I just messed around with the keyframes. I'll select both of them, right click and continuous bezier for both of them. Just to make things a little bit more smooth. So this was one kind of transition, and I'll just delete these keyframes real quick and I'll show you how I made the other one. It's almost similar. But instead of using the twirl angle, I just went and set the keyframe on rotation. So at the first cut, it's going to be from 0 to 0 to 90. I think I forgot to delete the keyframes over here. And then at the second cut, I'll select the rotation to be about minus 90, I think. Minus 90, and at the end of this I'm gonna select back to 0. So we get this kind of a transition. Now obviously this is boring. Again, I did the same thing. I choose these two keyframes and continuous bezier for both of them, and that is how I got this transition. Okay, so now I'll show you how to use this preset. First, you have to download the file that was given in the description, and which will give you three things. One is how to use, and this is the preset file, and this is the sound effect which I provided. And then in Premiere, right click on presets, select import presets, browse to the file that was provided and just double click on that. You're basically done. Now under presets, you can see a rotation transition free preset. Now there are four different presets, two in anti-clockwise, two in clockwise. You need to make a cut at the end of the first clip and at the beginning of the second clip. Shift plus left arrow key 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times, control K to make a cut. Go back and shift plus right 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times, control K to make a cut as well. Bigger the cut you make, longer is the transition going to be. Now that you've made the cuts, you can select whatever transition you want. So let's say clockwise. And so you've got rotation transition A, rotation transition B, twirl rotation transition A, twirl rotation transition B. So let's say I wanted rotation transition in clockwise. So the A part goes into the left cut and the B part goes into the right cut. and you're basically done. Now when you play it back, this is what you get. And the same thing, if you want twirl rotation transition, I'm gonna click and drag the A part onto the left cut and B part onto the right cut, and this is what you get. And you can also use the sound effect that I provided to make this even more better. So that's it for me in this video. If this video was helpful, please be sure to give it a like. And if it wasn't helpful, still give it a like, because I know these presets are useful. And if you're new, don't forget to subscribe, because if I make a new preset later on, you probably want to get that. Anyways, have a great day and thanks for watching.